I'm sure you remember the CL100 3D printer from the review I did on it. Neat, easy to use 3D printer, but with an incredibly slim enclosure, pretty much all the commenters on that video agree with that. So today, I'm going to take it apart and see if I can 3D print something a bit more sensible. Okay, as you can see, it's not just an enclosure, it holds some mechanical parts in place. Also, the stepper motor and the spool rod. Injection molding is pretty precise, usually more precise than 3D printing. We'll have to see if the CR10S Pro is up to the job. I was able to speak talk the engineers at Creality into sending me the complete CAD drawings for the CR100. What can I say? I'm persuasive. Now, with designing an injection molded part is complicated, it's beyond my modest CAD skills. I'm not embarrassed to say so. One day, I'll get there, but I'm not there yet. I do a lot of basic things well, but I'm not really an expert at anything. And this calls for an expert. So I went on Fiverr and have a part by CAD technician take care of it. This is Sirhit. I'm going to put a link to his profile in the comment section. Check that out. Beautiful, right? It would have taken me a week to get even close to that, and he did it in a day. But the rest is on me. I have to print this, see if I can put it all back together and have it still work. This is my Creality CR10S Pro printer. It's basically the printer I use every day. The early versions of the firmware have some issues, but that's all sorted now. I would say it takes longer to set up properly than an Ender 3, but once you do, the print quality is much better. I consider the best printer for its price and build area right now. But remember, I'm sponsored by Creality, so you should always watch reviews from Maker's Muse and other 3D printing channels first. A while back, Polymaker sent me a few rolls of filament. It's Polymaker 3D printer filament. It's fancy stuff, so I've been saving it. I think this is the perfect application. So you may have noticed something as it was printing. I don't often get bad prints off my Creality machines, but for those of you not familiar with 3D printing, I want you to see this. See those lines? That's garbage. I already saw the problem when I took this off the bed. Just a loose wheel, takes a second to fix. But I don't want you to get the idea from my videos that Creality or any 3D printer in the world is going to give you a perfect print every single time. But I've got my printer dialed in and up. It's not common. Okay, I am going to go print a proper one. Not bad. A lot better than the truck at least. But I do have to change the blue pieces here and there. Because Once the enclosure does hold mechanical parts in place, it's not a successful build until we test it. Okay, let's take a look. So this little bungee ball comes off from the CR tennis ball. It's pretty much perfect. And CR Tennis Pro is the top of the line 3D printer from Creality. I would expect it to be perfect because it's $600 and it does what it's supposed to do. Now, let's take a look at the $170 one, the CR100. Let's be kind. Don't be too hard on it. It's the first print out of the printer. So now let's take a look. By the way, I don't have the printer's profile. I was just guessing. So I think my setting is a bit off. You see on the top, it's missing the chimney, and on the side, the line is, there are some issues in general. But I'm confident enough that I don't think it's the printer's problem at all. I think the enclosure is fine, but it's more of a slicing issue. So I'm going to dial it in, mess it around, and change the setting. So next time I can show you what's the result of the change settings. I would call that a successful modification. I'll put the link to the SDL file in the description box. For those of you disappointed, I didn't do the CAD myself. I want to show you a realistic way to get it done than resort to camera cuts where it sort of implies I did something I did not. DIY does not mean you have to do every single thing yourself on every project, but you should know how everything is done or you're missing out. Okay, that's it for today. Because I have several sponsorship sites, I don't always see messages supporters send me there. I'm very sorry about that, but when I do see them, I do my best to respond. If you send a message and I did not get to it, my sincere apologies. In between builds and editing videos and everything else, I'm trying to be more organized about that. Thanks very much for your understanding and your support. Until next time, if I can do it, anyone can do it.